We stand before this company on this beautiful summer day to witness the joining of Bob and Christine. Blessed be all who attend this glorious celebration, and blessed be those who are about to be united in the bonds of love.
That's them.
Grab one of the late fathers.
You are aware of the reality of the vows you are about to speak to one another, of the responsibility that comes when a partnership is created. If there is any reason within your hearts that this ceremony should not continue at this time, I charge you to voice it now. You've had a month. 2 months, all right. For marriage is based in honesty and trust, and only those with those things that you can successfully create a partnership. Is there any reason known to you why this union should not proceed?
Anyone?
No giggling. Bob, will you have this woman to be your partner? To live together in marriage, will you love her, comfort her, honor, and keep her in sickness and in health for as long as love may last?
I will.
Christine, will you have this man to be your partner to live together in marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor, and keep him in sickness and in health for as long as love may last?
I will.
Christine and Bob, you stand before me, God, in this company, having desired the bond of marriage. You do this of your own free will, coming here today without coercion or pressure from other persons. No shotguns. Bob, will you seek to do her harm?
I will not.
If harm is done, will you seek to repair it?
I will.
Will you seek to be honest with her in all things?
I will.
Will you support her in times of distress?
I will.
Will you temper your words and actions with love?
I will.
Christine, will you seek to do him harm?
I will not.
If harm is done, will you seek to repair it?
I will.
Will you seek to be honest with him in all things?
I will.
Will you support him in times of distress?
I will.
Will you temper your words and actions with love?
I will.
Okay. These things you have promised to your partner, before this company and God, may you ever be mindful to strive to keep these vows that you have spoken. The Latin phrase, vitam impendere vero, means to consecrate one's life to truth. And so should truth be the meat of all your dealings in your marriage. Honesty, trust, communication, effort, understanding, and all these things are the building blocks of a firm marriage and your solemn responsibility to one another. At this moment, you should stand at the gateway between your old life and your new. Will all of you present here and witnessing these vows assist and support these two people in their union?
We will.
You are friends and relatives of this couple, and thus you are an important part of their lives. Now repeat after me. I, Bob, do ask you, Christine, to be my partner in marriage.
I, Bob, do ask you, Christine, to be my partner in marriage.
I ask that you accept my strength and my faults as I promise to accept yours.
I ask that you accept my
strengths
and my faults as I
promise
accept, as I promise to accept yours.
All right. They had better memories in those days.
Yes.
I ask for your support and strength when my own fails me.
I ask for your support and strength when my own fails me.
As I promise my strength and support in your times of need.
As I promise my strength and support in your times of need.
I bring you with best intention my love.
I bring you with best intention my love.
My understanding, all that I have and all that I am.
My understanding, all that I have and all that I am.
What little there is of it. I, Christine. Do take you, Bob, as my husband.
Do take you, Bob, as my husband.
I vow to you, my love and partner.
I vow to you, my love and my partner.
To be honest, understanding, and compassionate.
To be honest, understanding, and compassionate.
Loving and supportive.
Loving and supportive.
Even if I ask these things of you.
Even if I ask these things of you.
All this may God grant us for as long as our love shall last.
All this may God grant us for as long as our love shall last.
Now, if I could have your two inside hands, please. As this knot is tied, so are your lives now bound. Swear.
Now throw them in the river.
That'd be the first bath he'd have all year.
Now you will feel no pain, for each of you will be the shelter for the other. Now you will feel no cold, for each of you shall be the warmth of the other. Now there is no more loneliness for you. Now there is no more loneliness. Now you are two bodies, but there is only one life before you. Go now to your dwelling place and enter into the days of your togetherness. And may your days be good and long upon this earth. And you may now kiss.
Unions would like to honor you in song, sir.
Oh, all right. See, there is music after. Ladies and gentlemen,
we have known Bob and Christine for many years now. They are great friends to the unions, and we would like to honor them in song today with original lyrics and an original tune that I'm sure will be destined to be popular one day. The lyrics, I'm sure you will find, will warm the heart and melt the brain.
Gentlemen, if you please.
Take me out to the wedding. Take me out with the squirrels. Christine, you are lovely, and that's the truth. We hope that the judge won't be droopy for you. So let's root, root, root for Bob and Christine. Congrats to you, let us say that it's hip, 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 hooray on your wedding day.
Congratulations.
Well done, sir.